Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Doctor Sleep, a novel book by Stephen King. She takes center stage along with Dan and a few other characters for the second half. Dan must stop a group of sludging vampires of sorts, called the True Knot, from feasting on Abra and her abilities. His use of telepathy for Abra to take over Don's body often seemed a bit too convenient and overused. He writes prose and dialogue that's realistic and sounds like you're having a conversation with your best friend, even when the dialogue gets to be a bit on the fantastic side. There is plenty here to remind you of The Shining, but it's not a direct sequel. There is a little about it, but not forced, just information that relates to the main character's self. This novel is not a sequel in any way. It is a masterful, sobering, and compelling look at a character who survived evil. Halloran's student is called on to become a teacher to another gifted and targeted young person, the wonderful little girl, Abra. In many ways, this is Abra's story, and her connection to Dan was a surprise, and very fitting. The evil troop rolling across the landscape are an insidious, pitiless group of predators who are portrayed in a nuanced way, and the King delves deeper into what drives these True Knot predators while showing that evil does attract evil. Dr. Sleep is further proof that Stephen King is one of this generation's, or any generation's, for that matter, most cherished storytellers. There's a lot of realism here, and it just shows how large the author's heart is. This is a book for anyone that's been kicked around a bit, and not necessarily by addiction, but by any number of life's conundrums, but found the strength to stand and do something important. You need to read the rest and find out who Rose the Hat and the True Knot is, and what they do. As for the Overlook Hotel, well, that has burnt down to the ground in a boiler explosion, The Shining along with Jack Torrance. It isn't light by any stretch, lol, but it is much lighter than The Shining. The beginning is the roughest part, with Danny doing some terrible things, rough language, and other characters that were less than sympathetic. In a world where things seem to change daily, it's great to know that some things don't. This ends up becoming a point of suspense, almost more so than the supernatural elements. But even if you haven't read The Shining, this works as a standalone piece. The backstory requires you know The Shining to fully understand it, but the book develops its own plot and characters to make it interesting and enjoyable. He is plagued by his past, the aftermath of the Overlook incident, his father's death, his shining abilities, alcoholism, and chronic unemployment homelessness. King also does a great job bringing Abra to life, describing an amazing young girl who is strong, yet susceptible to childhood adolescent fears. The reader is taken on an amazing adventure into Dan Torrance's adult life, and the plot's twists and turns keeps the reader on his or her toes, uncertain if all the heroes and heroines overcome the True Knot unscathed. This is a great ending to a nightmare of a life for a lonely, special little boy. His writing is so rich and layered that he'd never be able to cover all the ground his fans would want. Sometimes leaving a sequel up to the mind of the reader is the best way to go. The story really explores what The Shining is, along with some interesting twists like steam. Perhaps as King himself is getting older, this is on his mind a good bit, but there really aren't any younger characters besides Abra to create action or drama. Abra's parents are perhaps the go-between, but they are the classic overprotective I don't believe advice is happening parental types. They won't be able to ignore it when they make this one into a movie. Dr. Sleep is, as with any King novel under 600 pages in length, expertly plotted. Young Danny Torrance progresses through a disturbed adolescence and a very difficult adulthood, plagued by both ghosts and demons, ghosts from the Overlook Hotel and the demon of alcohol that helped destroy his father. Meanwhile, at the same time, the True Knot are working their way across America, vampiric humanoids in RV caravans who travel the country looking to steal the psychic essence that dwells in telepathic young children. And, as the novel progresses, become obsessed with stalking and murdering a young girl named Abra, who's herself developed a very tight bond with a now 40 Dan Torrance. Much of the rest of the book is given over to Don's journey through the 12 steps. And, in case the AA connection wasn't enough to establish this book as after-school special material, you'll also learn a lot more about Dan Torrance's family tree. There's plenty of room left open for another sequel, either with True Knot or with Abra herself. More of a combination horror and adventure tale than an outright horror novel, Stephen King's Dr. Sleep was engrossing and fun. The story takes off when Dan is distracted from his own issues by a young girl also blessed or cursed with a shining ability, a girl who is targeted by a traveling group of psychic vampires who feed on children with her unique attributes, likable yet nuanced supporting characters including Aubra's parents, and Don's friends from Alcoholics Anonymous, and decent attention to Don's own issues round out the proceedings, all making for yet another strong, late career entry from Mr. Little Danny Torrance from The Shining had the gift of communicating with others who also shined, as well as seeing certain parts of the past, and the future. As noted above, the gift of The Shining described in the original story has morphed into something almost completely unrecognizable. Stephen King could have changed Danny's name, and left out all references to the first book with hardly any impact on the overall story. In the usual King fashion, the plot is imaginative, the characters are compelling, and the descriptions of the surroundings are excellent, and make you feel like you are there. Read it, and enjoy it, but don't try to compare it to the original because it is just so different. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, and leave your comments below.